Oh. Sorry, I got some fur in my throat. Cause I've just had a haircut. I think it makes me look younger. I haven't really had a haircut cause I don't have hair, I've got fur. What? Why are you laughing at that? It's true. Excited cause I watched Hawaii 5-0 on CBS last night. I thought it was really good, except the portrayal of rabbits. I noticed they didn't have much in the way of rabbits, which seems a shame because Hawaii, of course, is famous for rabbits. They've got rabbits in Hawaii, and the rabbits go like this. I tell you, if you was a rabbit, you would think I was really sexy. Anyway, I watched, because I've got a DVR, I watched Dancing with the Stars, and I think that show is. Right, go ahead and clap, but 15 million of watched it. I think that show is bollocks. You got people with that situation dancing around. I'm like, when did he become a star? And then all them dancing, I'm like, what is this? Is just like an evening with some. If I wanted that, I'd go to my family's house. All I'm saying is I have noticed in my life that I tend to not like what everyone else likes. For example, lots of people like Dancing with the Stars. I don't. Lots of people like Justin Bieber. I don't. The good news is that when a show is on this late at night, it doesn't really matter what I think. But let me just say this. Our day will come. Our day will come. Join me, people who don't like what everyone else likes, and we'll become the ones who get things made on TV for us. Like Cussing with the Rabbits. Now, watch that.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Kia Motors and the all-new 2011 Sportage, the perfect crossover for the road ahead.
Everybody, all right, that's enough. Sit down. All right, so excited. This audience really means it. Not like the other audiences. All the other audiences have been here. They chat. They were clear. But this one. No, I think this audience may be just as phony as the rest. I like phonies, though. That's why I live in Hollywood, California. I don't need sincerity or honesty. I just need you to fake it enough for me to believe it. That's all. What kind of a day is it? I'll tell you. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, it is. Last night I did my new thing where I went like that, and then I thought I'd do jazz hands to this side tonight, and everyone's very excited about it. And it was a great day for America. Not a great day for gays in the military, though. Today, the Senate blocked the repeal of the Don't Ask, Don't Tell. Members of the gay community are very upset. They're so upset with the Senate, they have threatened to stop having sex with them. Now, wait till you hear, this is quite interesting. There's a musical company in Arkansas is making an opera based on the life of Bill Clinton. I want to see it. I'm not sure how it ends, but I bet it isn't with a fat lady singing. You can't mean, yes, I do mean that. It's a great day for us here at... because I'm pretty drunk. I'm not, you'd know, trust me. You'd know by the test pattern going up, because I would be here if I was drunk. Anyway, it's a great day for us here at CBS. Last night, the premiere of Hawaii Five-O, it was huge. The ratings came in today. 13.8 million people watched it. And to give you an idea of how many people that is, take the number of people who watch this show, add 13.8 million, and right there.
Oh, my.
Yeah. Now, this is what happens with ratings information. The networks have teams of guys in suits. They're sort of magical nerds, and their job is to take the numbers and make them sound good, no matter what they are. Now, the magical nerds break down the ratings into demographics. So like this, the Hawaii Five-O did well with men aged 18 to 34 and women aged 24 to 49, but it did poorly with babies 0 to 1 and... geezers 118 to 128. It really gets that specific, really. I mean, this show apparently does very well with certain demographics. People in federal prisons love this show. It's true, the prisoners feel a sense of kinship with me in this tiny little dark cell with skinny gay dude hitting on me most of the time.
Did I mention I'm single?
The show does well with prisoners. We don't do well with other demographics, like pirates. Don't do well with pirates. I go to bed early and I don't have a DVR. For advertisers, the reason they break it down into demographics for the advertisers, the most coveted. Take a breath. Right, the most coveted demographic is 18 to 49. Now, I'm 48 years old, which means I've only got 1 year left of being coveted. Then, what they think is, I have to buy all the stuff I'm ever going to need. I've got 1 year left. For the rest of my life, I have to buy everything I'm going to need. So I'm going to need Bengay and toothpaste. And I better not mix them up. That would never happen. I always know the smell of Bengay.
Hello
yourself. Hawaii Five-O, that's what I'm talking about. It's, of course, a remake of the cop show from the 1970s. It starred Jack Lord as Steve McGarrett. Do we have a picture of him? No. There he is. Now, see that? That's not a graphic. He used to carry a little sign around with that. Look. Yeah. Walk into bars and go, yeah, it's me, yeah. His catchphrase, though, was "Book 'em, Dano," which is a great line. It prevented him from working with anyone else besides Dano. Now, book 'em, Dano. Actually, I'm Charlie. Dano's got the flu. Then we're going to have to let him go. But the show proves that you can, you know, you can remake old shows and as long as you make them sexier, you see? Basically, Hollywood is taking old shows and shooting them full of Botox, because the old Hawaii Five-O... In the old Hawaii Five-O, Steve McGarrett had a sidekick named Kono, and Kono was a local who would help him out if he got in a tight spot. Now, do we have a picture of the old Kono from the old show? That's Kono there, right? Now, do we have a picture of the new Kono from the... that's the new Kono. I'm not kidding. You know that was amazing? And that's the same dude. Look at that guy. Now, that's... There's your laying off the carbs. Now, one of the reasons why Hawaii Five-O looks so good is it's actually shot in Hawaii. Hawaii is beautiful, but it's important to wear plenty of sunblock. Like when they were filming that show Lost, half of the cast got serious sunburns on the first day because they used up all the sunblock on the fat guy. They didn't. They did. He was too hairy. He did. He had hair. He was like, hair is a natural sun. Does hair... Here's a natural sunblock. Like, I don't put sunblock on my hairy parts. If you go out sunbathing, do you put sunblock on your hairy parts? Well, you're like a monkey. You probably don't need sunblock. Now, you don't have skin. Hawaii, yeah. Whenever I go to Hawaii, I make sure I bring my scuba gear. Like, when I go to Arizona, I make sure I bring my papers. Did you just ooh me there? I got an ooh. I wish this show was taped in Hawaii because I always wanted to wear a coconut bra. Because people in Hawaii wear them, I've decided. No, I'm wearing a coconut bra right now.
In your pants.
In my pants. I would do that. I would wear a coconut bra. Would you wear a coconut bra?
No. No.
Why not?
Craig, Craig, Craig.
It's time for... Oh, look what I found on the camera. Look. Yeah, you know, the CBS clearly spent all the money on Hawaii Five-O. And they got some cameramen in here who normally do wedding videos. Yeah. Oh, that's good. Does that make me look younger? Is that why it's on? Oh, look, it's, who used to, they used to Star Trek, they used to do that all the time. Like, Captain Kirk would be like, and then the alien would come on and be like, well, you might as well know the truth. There I am. We'll take a break. When we come back... It'll be much the same. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back to the show where we like what everybody else likes. My first guest tonight is the star of The Middle, which the season premieres tomorrow night on ABC. But it's good. Take a look at this.
We cannot be late for the first day of school. Let's go, let's go. Where is Axel? Brick, go get your brother up.
Axel, get up.
Did you brush your teeth?
Sorry, I guess I'm out of the habit from summer.
Here, rinse and spit.
Where are my school supplies?
Mike, where are the school supplies?
I don't know. You said you were going to steal some from work.
I've taken too much. Ellard is on to me. This is just not a good way to start my first year on cross country.
We got a bowling pencil and a paperclip. That's all you need for first day.
Oh, Rick, you left a sandwich in here from last year. That's disgusting. And you got an A on your I Love Winter paper. Good job.
God, when did I even make egg salad? Oh, it's not egg salad. Oh.
We please welcome the lovely Patricia Heaton, everybody. What do you mean?
What is it, a snake?
Yeah, you've seen that before. Oh. It's my Freudian compensation for a small penis thing.
Okay, glad I asked.
Yeah, well, how are you doing? You all right?
I'm doing great.
Yeah,
yeah.
Good. You look great. You look very nice.
I'm working on
it.
It's hard. You like the purple. It's
a
good TV color.
Yeah. It's a nice TV color. Yeah. It reminds me of Prince and... A lot of very, it's a bishop's color, isn't it? Don't bishops wear purple?
I think so, yeah. Yeah. Prince, though.
Prince? Do you like Prince?
I do like Prince.
I always
very talented.
Really?
I wish he would do a gospel album. He'd be great at a gospel album.
He probably is watching right now.
He probably is.
No, I don't know. I don't know that he would do. Maybe he should do gospel. I don't know much about gospel music. Do you follow gospel music?
Well, you know, my first job on Broadway, I was in the chorus of a black gospel musical. I was one of two white singers in the show.
Oh.
And it was called Don't Get God Started.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
But you probably did get him started, didn't you?
Started. And I remember my manager at the time was this gal, Pat Sullivan.
Pat Sullivan? Yeah. I don't know Pat Sullivan, yeah. But I like her already.
Yeah, she's like that. She's like,
Pat, a guy or a lady?
Woman.
A woman, yeah, yeah.
Yes. She's like, Patty, you go to church, don't you? I'm like, yeah. Why don't you go try out for this show? You need a gospel song. And I'm like, well, I go to a Catholic church, and, you know, what kind of show? Yeah, just go sing a song. Well, I get there, it's like the black Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir and me auditioning for the thing.
What's a tabernacle?
Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir, it's like the best black gospel choir in New York.
Yeah, I know, but what's a tabernacle? A tabernacle's a church? I don't know what a tabernacle is. I've heard it. I know it's connected with a church. I know it's a churchy word, but I didn't know the actual tabernacle.
The tabernacle would be like the interior, like holy of holies.
Really?
Yes.
Tabernacle?
Yes.
It's kind of an adorable word for something like that.
Yes.
Little old tabernacle right there.
Yes.
So there, the tabernacle.
So that's just the name of this choir.
Right,
but anyway,
right.
So it's all them and me. And I had just come from like a commercial for like Palmolive soap, like I was auditioning. So I was like in a denim skirt and a white blouse and a red knit vest with a scarf. And I go in and it's like, hey, Miss Heaton, what are you going to sing for us today? And it's like, well, I have something. It's sort of like a gospel song. It's not really a gospel song, but I'll sing it for you. And I'm like, okay, whatever, you know.
I sang
a song called Suddenly Seymour from Little Shop of Horrors.
I know that song!
Yeah. For my black gospel musical audition.
You got the
and
job!
I got the job!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well done!
You know, it was one of these things where they kind of wanted to test if I really had rhythm, and so at the callback they made us do this. You know, oh, I see, I didn't even do it there.
Yeah, I don't know if you'd get it now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, it's kind of one of those things in a gospel choir.
Yeah.
Right. And my friend Norwood Young, who lives down the street from me now in LA,
right.
He looks over at me and he goes, we know who they're testing when they're making us all do that step. Because I was the only white person there.
Really?
Yes, but I got the job. And by the way, so Norwood and I are both, we both get the job and we're in this choir
together.
I'm glad
together. I asked this question.
Yes.
I mean, it's really, I mean, some people don't give a comprehensive answer, Patty, but my Lord, you're really bringing your A game tonight. In fact, I don't really need to be here. You take the cup and I'll bugger off. Right, Norwood lives down the street. You and Norwood still talk. That's adorable.
But Norwood has the house in L.A. that has the 18 statues of David in the front.
Oh, you know that guy?
Yes.
That's Norwood?
Oh, we were in a black house together.
I love that house.
27 years ago.
There's this house in LA. If you don't know LA, there's a house you drive by. It's on 3rd Street.
Yes, right.
And it's all outside is all these different plinths with all different size statues of Michelangelo's David.
Yes, there's 18 of them surrounding the driveway.
And the house is painted, and it drives the neighbors crazy,
oh,
right?
Oh, well, I just adore it. And especially at Christmas, because he puts a Santa hat on every statue of David.
Miss Heaton, take me home with you.
Sorry about that. I don't
Oh, you have an addition to the show.
Oh, you haven't met? No, it's my sidekick. CBS really showed up with the money this year.
Hello.
They got me an appliance as a sidekick.
Does it have a name?
Yeah, it is Jeff Peterson. He's a gay robot. And,
my.
Well,
I don't know if he's gay. His junk hasn't arrived. It's stuck in customs.
Is that junk? You mean junk? Is that a word? Is that a euphemism for...
For gentleman's equipment?
Oh.
Yeah.
Like luggage.
Do you say luggage?
Right. Is that what you call it? Luggage?
Well, I have to carry it around, I suppose, but... I have to. Well, you've got four boys. You've probably.
I do, yes.
Yeah, so you probably used all sorts of different words for them.
And by the way, I have to say, because I completely forgot, happy birthday, Sam. It's today. I forgot.
Oh, it's so lovely your mother decided to appear in a late night television show on your birthday. Happy birthday.
I've forgotten a lot of stuff. I forgot to pick up my son from camp this summer. I forgot a birthday today. I'm really. And I forgot the back to school night last week.
Are you on a lot of medication right now,
Brian? I'm not on enough medication.
Right,
that's the problem.
No. Yeah.
So it's I have a lot. It's sort of like the show. You know, my character's always trying to stay on top of everything, and I'm trying to stay on top of everything. It's just my life and the character's life are completely one and the same.
Really?
So, yeah.
So that's what the show's about. It's about the
running after the kids and stuff. Yeah. And you know, it's kind of a celebration.
You don't do that. You're a Hollywood big shot. You probably got nannies
and stuff. I don't know. I really love being with my kids. In fact, my husband and I realized that we had not been alone together for 2 years now, because we are always doing stuff with the kids. So, but we really enjoy it. I mean, they're funny. You know, the other day I was with Dan in the car, and we were comparing epic movie songs. So it was, who was the best one? The theme from Rocky, Eye of the Tiger, or The Final Countdown?
Oh, Final Countdown.
No!
Yeah,
no,
final.
No, no, no.
It's the final countdown.
So, exactly. But what's really fun is my 11-year-old, we listen to each one. He's got his iPod as we're driving to school, you know, and he's like, Rocky, and he's like, yeah. And then Eye of the Tiger and The Final Countdown. And he's like, Mom, Bill Conti, what can you say? And he's 11.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh, he's, you know, it's that kind of stuff that's so much fun.
Yeah, no, it's good. You know what? I was driving with my son into the parking lot at school, and there was a kid that he hadn't seen for the whole summer.
Yes.
And he sees him getting out of his parents' car, and he says, well, if it isn't William. Just like that.
How old is he?
Nine. Well, if it isn't William. We've got to take a break. We'll be right back. We'll be right back with Patricia Heaton, everybody.
Sorry. We'll include you.
Yeah, no, we've never met before. We were just catching up. We used to be in a gospel choir together. I think was that your idea then when you were starting out? You wanted to be working on Broadway and you ended up with Raymond?
Well, yeah, I mean, I'll just take a job wherever I could get it, you know?
Really?
Yeah, well, But, you know, a lot of people say to me, how do you choose between all the offers that you get? And I'm like, you know what? I get one call a year and I always say yes.
Yeah.
That's how I choose.
I know people say this. People think it's a very kind of privileged life. I get the same question people say to me, oh, when you were drinking, how much did you drink? I'm like, I don't know. It's not Weight Watchers. I didn't keep a diary. You don't wake up in the dumpster and go, 14 units last night. Uh-oh. Do you have that problem with your excessive drinking?
I have... I have had, you don't drink anymore.
No, not anymore.
Yes,
no,
I don't.
Hence the pants.
Yeah, hence the pants.
Hence the pants, yeah. If
pants.
I was still drinking, I wouldn't be wearing
right,
pants.
Right, yes. Yeah. You know, it's interesting. I've had to pretty much stop drinking.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you're not much of a drinker.
Well, there was a period from college was just forget about it.
Right.
And then New York, that's another 9 years, forget about
right,
that.
Right, right. And then... Our pattern begins to emerge.
And then I had kids, and I was like...
Wait! Kids was a big drinking part of your life?
It's really interesting. When they're little, it's so intensive, the work, and it's nonstop. And when you get them to bed, I would get up in the morning thinking, orange juice or a beer? Is it too early for a beer? And I would be, at the end of the day, I'd be so tense that I just needed to calm down and
do they know about this in the tabernacle?
I put the kids down to bed, and then I went downstairs and I poured myself a glass of red wine. And then, of course, one of them says, "Mom, could you come back? I'm giving another snuggle." And I went back up, and he's like, "Mom,
you smell like Santa."
No. No. Even better, he said, "Mom, you smell like communion."
Oh.
And I was like, that's exactly what I was doing in the kitchen, and taking communion.
Taking communion in the kitchen.
Yes, but I have just found, I'm a lady of a certain age now.
Me too.
And yes, and I cannot process alcohol anymore.
Yeah.
It wakes me up in the middle of the night if I have a glass of wine. And
you
so
can
I,
drink through that, but if you really...
You can,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you're really committed,
yeah, you could woke up, oh, keep drinking, and then you can get past
it. But you know, the other thing is this schedule on the middle. With Raymond, I worked from like 10 to 4, and kind of an easy schedule. This, I started at 6 o'clock this morning, so I was up at 5, and, you know, worked from 6. And I had a half day today, so I was done by 1 o'clock. But normally you work from 6 till about 8 at night,
and
longer.
Like
so I can't afford to look bad in the morning, and I will if I drink.
Well, you look sensational, and you're just it's lovely to see you,
you
again.
Too.
Lovely. Patricia Eaton, everybody. We'll be right back. Enough of your hugely believable applause. My next guest is an actor. He's in a new film called The Romantics, which is in theatres now. Please welcome Adam Brody, everybody. Adam Brody. Welcome, Adam. Lovely to see you now.
Thank you. You're
feeling a little bit sick. Is that right?
I'm a little under the weather, but I'm making a comeback. I don't know. I didn't exactly take anything. I just took it as an opportunity to sleep. Look how shiny and disgusting my hands are.
Yeah, that's.
I just like greased up.
Keep going then.
I'll just. Yeah.
Don't put that in your hair. You'll kill you off the essential mites and creatures that live in your hair.
I'm growing dreads, so that's...
Are you really
that
growing dreads?
That was a bad idea.
What?
No, I don't know.
No, you'll be all right. You'll be fine with that. It's mostly alcohol.
Oh. Well, fresh in my cup.
No, you're all right. So tell me about your film then, Adam. What's The Romantics? Is it, action movie?
It's an action movie about, like, six people who went to Yarvard together about... 10 years ago, Yarvard's like a.
What's
it called? Call it a composite of Harvard
and Yale.
And, yeah.
Yeah.
And really. They don't say in the movie. I think we actually went to Yale. It's just a terrible joke. All right, just let me know.
Oh well, fitting well with the rest of the show. You'll be good. Yeah.
They get back together for a reunion. Two of them are getting married together, and so they have a sort of reunion. And they.
Does anything go on fire in this movie? Does anyone get blown up?
Is anyone? I mean, emotionally. Emotionally, everything's on fire. It's really raw. It's dangerous.
It's a movie about feelings, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Where are you from, then?
I'm from San Diego.
I've just been to San Diego.
What were you doing in San Diego?
I was at SeaWorld, and they have an excellent zoo there, and it's near Legoland. Do you ever go to Legoland?
They've got all those theme parks, and no, I was too old for Legoland by the time that came around.
Legoland is awesome. You can go now. You're not too old. Go the only thing is, I was at Legoland this summer, and we had to evacuate the water slide because someone pooped in it.
Is that true?
Yeah, it's true. Someone pooped in the water slide, and everybody had to get out while the poop team went in and captured it.
That sounds really traumatic. Like I shouldn't go there, then. It's not an endorsement.
Maybe you could go and help.
Maybe I go and poop.
Don't poop in the water slide. That's not right.
At Legoland, I would think that would be a SeaWorld thing, the water.
The fish are allowed to poop at SeaWorld because it's their environment.
Yeah. And it's beautiful when it's in nature and it's in the natural environment. It's actually a beautiful cycle of life.
It's the circle of life, the wheel of fortune. Did you ever try and join an all-African-American choir?
It was a basketball team.
I
didn't make the cut.
All right, okay. So you went to school in San Diego? You're from San Diego?
I'm from San Diego. I went to school in San Diego, and I moved up to Los Angeles when I was 19.
Really?
Yep. And it was a bummer. You sound sad about that.
Well, a 19
years
old. No, I didn't
think it was a mistake.
No, I think you're doing good. You're in the movie with these people having emotions. There's no tornado, but, you know.
There's a rainstorm.
People have feelings, and there you go. What kind of movies do you like to watch?
I like them all, you know. I actually think I...
Really?
I do. I mean, I don't like every movie, but I like every genre, I should say.
Really? Zombie movies? You like zombie movies?
Yeah, I do. Shaun of the Dead.
Shaun of the Dead's
a great movie.
The remake
of Dawn of the Dead was good, and then I know there's a lot of older good ones that I don't actually...
Right.
...haven't really seen. George Romero.
What about the new vampire movies with the vampires that have got feelings?
I'm trying to think of my favorite vampire. Well, I like to see the Let Me In remake, the Swedish movie that's called Let Me In
Now. I've seen that.
I like that a lot.
No, not
for you. Why? What didn't work?
It's foreign. Swedish, yeah.
Subtitles.
They
make it in American.
They're remaking,
it's coming out soon, so we won't have to read.
What about werewolves? Do you like the werewolves?
I like a good weir. I mean, sure. What, werewolf movies? I haven't seen an American Werewolf in London.
That's a great movie.
Is it?
That is a great movie. The American Werewolf in Paris,
not as good. Yeah. I've seen, yes.
Yeah,
I've
see,
seen
that's that not, the, I mean, it, didn't, it just didn't work because, you know, the Parisians were all rude to the werewolf. They're like, I don't know where it is. Maybe you can ask someone in French. But the American Werewolf in London is a fantastic movie. John Landis,
yes.
I think.
Yes, I heard they were maybe
Well, please tell me they're not
remaking. They're going to Botox it up, remake it. As
like Hawaii 5-0?
Yeah.
And an American Werewolf in Hawaii would be awesome.
That's a great idea, and there's not like a sun problem with them.
No,
so
werewolves
that's fine.
Are fine in the sun.
As long as full moon.
You probably have to shave them a bit because it gets very hot.
But then you'd want to put some suntan lotion on them because wouldn't want them to get red. But dogs can burn.
Well, this is the problem I had earlier on. I don't know. Do you wear sunscreen, or do hairy people wear a lot of sunscreen? Does hair protect you from the sun?
I think to a point.
Right.
But I mean, yeah. I think that's the general idea. You shouldn't have to.
So
sunscreen up your head if you've got a full head of hair.
But you can get sunburn on your scalp. Maybe you should wear a hat over your entire body.
I mean, I think a Surgeon General will tell you that a hat is a good idea out in the sun.
Do you know the Surgeon General?
Is there just one? I used to think he was the Colonel Sanders-looking guy that would be on HBO. He looked like him, and he would say the Surgeon General.
I'm not from San Diego, I don't think it's Colonel Sanders.
I've been going to the wrong doctor.
It's Colonel Sanders. Colonel Sanders is the imposter who doesn't really do fried chicken. He just fried duck. Colonel Sanders fried duck. What about one of these puppies, eh?
I know, that's an impressive snake.
Thanks very much indeed. It's because I've got a small penis.
What does this say about me?
Says you're a lucky man.
Hey, sir.
So, we're out of time. Are you going back to San Diego tonight, or are you just going to keep staying
in LA? No, I live here. I've lived here for
I know, but
10
I thought
years.
You might decide, this is it. I'm now going back to San Diego.
I mean, my parents live there. I might call them.
Don't call them now. It's too late. It's after midnight in many areas.
But they'll be up watching me on the show. Supportive parents.
Don't they have DVRs?
Yeah, but they're going to want to get this live, I think.
Yeah.
I don't think they're going to want to miss it.
Well, you could call them. Yeah, they'll be awake right now in this late time period.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. Wait. Don't you dare applaud. Do you fancy an awkward pause?
Yeah, can we go out on that?
Yeah, sure. Well, sure. Okay. I've started already. Musical or non-musical awkward?
I mean, we have to pause.
Yeah, we'll pause.
All right. Non-musical would be more awkward.
Okay.
We're both sick.
Yeah, no.
Sorry about that. You shouldn't drink that anymore.
I think I might be pregnant. Actually. Adam Brody, everybody. Welcome back, everybody. My next guest has the number one album in the country. She's here to sing King of Anything. Please welcome Sarah Bareilles, everybody. Sarah Bareilles.
Keep quiet and count the cards.
entertainment. Good night.